and welcome to another edition of Fitness 365. I'm your host, Joyce Jackson. As the season changes to spring, we were wondering when is a good time to make changes to your workout routine, your eating plan, or your total approach to health and fitness. Also on the show, a young kickboxer who's changing his status from amateur to pro this month. We will talk with Jared Tipton about his journey. On this Fitness 365 journey with me is the owner and founder of Advanced Sports Performance and Strength and Conditioning Expert, D'Angelo Kennard. Welcome, D'Angelo.
How you doing, Joyce?
I'm doing great. Another episode of Fitness 365. A lot of things going on with us. Our colleague, Leona Brown, could not be with us, but we're going to show you one of her classic routines that can give you a spark to your workout plan. D'Angelo, a big question about change right now. Is change necessary, and when is a good time to make changes to the workout routine?
Absolutely. I mean, with the seasons changing, it's always a good mark to increase your intensity, maybe vary your routine, whatever it may be, but keep it fun. We want to make fitness a lifetime commitment, so we always want to change. As our body evolves, so does our routine.
So how often do you change? Do you change every workout? Do you change every month? Do you change every 3 months or every season?
Just depends on your level. Okay. I mean, in the beginning, you want to make sure that your goals are achievable. So monthly would be a good way to factor in change. If you're an athlete, it depends on competition, mm-hmm. your times throughout the year. But like I said, quarterly, as with the seasons, is always a good place to start.
Now, you know Jared, the kickboxer we're going to be talking to later on.
Absolutely.
He must be making a lot of different changes to his workout because each opponent is going to be different.
Absolutely. And he grows as an athlete throughout his lifetime. So, you know, he's going from amateur to professional. Now, for us, we train like professionals regardless of amateur or pro. Mm-hmm. But with professional status, there are new challenges, and of course, we want to make some tweaks to his routine.
But there are benefits to variety. I always hear people saying you got to hit the muscle from different angles.
Right.
At first, I didn't know what that meant until I started working with you and Leona. So change and variety is, what are the benefits? It's a good thing.
Well, the good thing is you think about the body, it is a smart machine. So it adapts very quickly. So in order to elicit continued benefits and continued results, you want to change. So maybe that's intensity in terms of your weights, your duration if you're doing cardio, or just in the type of workout you're doing overall. So if you're geared more toward cardio and running, you want to add some more weights. If you like the weights and bands and resistance movements, maybe you want to take up yoga, which I've done myself because it allows your body to be challenged in a different area. Yes, the big man can do a little yoga too. But always keeping it fun. That's a big thing.
Yeah, so change is a good thing. Always Absolutely. Keep the body guessing. Right now, we're going to throw it over to our colleague, Leona Brown, for a plyometric workout.
Hello, everybody. Just as Joyce Jackson said, we're going to work on some plyometric movements. Plyometrics are very important in running. It's good for explosiveness, for speed, especially when you're getting into the deeper parts of the race for you marathon runners, your 20 mile, 22, and 25 miles. So I have my training partner here, Darnell Strong Soul Murphy, who is actually a pro fighter. He's got his pro debut November 15th. So excited to have you here with us today, and we're going to get some workout on, okay?
Sounds good.
All right. One of the first movements that we're going to do is what we call a jump squat. Okay, so what we're going to do is show you in stages, and then we'll go through the movement, the complete movement afterwards. So the most important thing to realize is that it's more of a joint action. So you're going to come from your ankles to your knees to your hips, all of those joints working together. It's a very explosive movement. So first of all, Darnell, I want you to go ahead in a squat position. All right, he's going to keep his heels to the ground. Arms elongated, pointed down to the ground for the explosive movement. The power is going to come from his quads. So as he powers down, springing up, and dropping back down. You're going to be very careful when you do this movement not to come straight down on the balls of your feet, on the flat part of your feet. You want to come down nice and easy. So come down on the balls of your feet and landing back down. Showing you from the side profile view, really, really focusing on the core, really, really focusing on the quads. And this time, they're not really focused on the explosive part and coming all the way up, extending those arms up to the ceiling, okay?
All right.
And go ahead and load those quads for me. And up. Good. Perfect. And one more. That is an excellent squat jump. Relax. Transitioning to the next movement, another plyometric movement, squats. It's the same motion. Now we're going to go to the lunge. We're going to do a lunge with the jump. It's going to be the same distance. So, but this time, Darna, you're going to put your right leg forward and extend. Just come back just a little bit for me and extend the left leg back. So this is going to be the same motion as you did with the squats, but this time it's going to be isolated with the lunge. It's really isolating that quad. Same exact thing with the joint action, ankles, knees, hips, and then going back down. So we'll go from step to step and then do the whole complete motion. Okay, Darnell? Starting to get a sweat already, aren't you?
Yeah, it's working.
Exactly. Ready? So motion one is the power move, exploding down, then coming straight up, and then coming back down. Now the key thing is to not extend that back leg too far out. You want to keep it in line with your hips. And this is the front leg. You don't want that knee to extend over to the toe. Okay? So now we're going to do one full movement. And up and go back down. Right. So when you land, I'm going to turn you this way, Darnell. Okay, same motion so you can get a nice side profile view. It's very important when you land not to land too far back on that heel. You want to land perfectly, balls of your feet first. Coming down, remember the joint action, hips, knees, and ankles. One full movement, Darnell, ready? Okay. And begin. Go up, one, down, good. Two, one more, and relax. Now this motion, you can do about three sets of these, about 10. What I like to do is mix it up, do one jump squat, one lunge, one jump squat, one lunge. That way you always keep the heart rate going, getting that full body movement. And as you can see, he is sweating pretty bad right there. Yeah. So we're gonna transition to the next movement. More plyometrics, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in the heavy ball. Darnell's not going to have to throw it. You can either use a heavy ball, you can use a resistance ball. So what we're going to do is what we call mountain climbers. All right? Okay. Now, you may not think this is not a plyometric movement, but actually it is because you're working on the speed of your hips, constantly moving back and forth. And what most runners don't concentrate is the hip flexors. So we really want to focus on that. So what Darnell's going to do is going to get out on the medicine ball here. All right, there's two different ways that you can do this, palms down or forearms. So we're going to show you both ways. Now, the thing with the mountain climber is to make sure that your body is aligned and straight, almost 180 degrees, okay? So I'm going to show you this front portion first, and then we're going to give you a side view so you can see how the movement actually goes. Now, here's the key. You want to stabilize your core, firm hips here. What we're going to do is we're going to bring our knees to the inside of our elbows here. Bring it in and release it. All right, same thing with the other side. Now, when you're doing this regular pace, it's not going to be slow like that. It's going to be a fast-paced movement. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a side profile view. So then we're going to stand up and we're going to turn this way, put this medicine ball in front. I'm going to help you out because you got that fight on November 15th. Sure. So you want to save all that little bit of energy for you, okay?
Yes,
so, giving you that side profile view. Very good form, very good base. Go ahead and show them the forearm one too, Darnell, real quick. So put your forearms on the medicine ball as well. And you can also do it. Now with this one, real good core stabilization right here, okay? All right, so now come back up, palms flat, and let's just go through the mountain climbers together and exercise go. Good. Keeping the back flat, making sure the core stabilized, and moving through and out, and relax. How's that feel? Felt good?
Burn.
Now, here's the thing. For you more advanced runners and advanced workouts, I'm going to show you one more move. We're going to go back down to that position. So you're already sweating, right? Absolutely. It doesn't take much if you're doing the exercise correctly. So we're going to go back down, hands on the medicine ball. What we're going to do is, we're still using the explosive movements, activating the core, activating the hamstrings and the quads. What we're going to do is we're going to take left knee is going to go to the right elbow and out. Push it in and push it out. In and out. What this is working on right now, one more time, Darnell, working on the hips and pulling out, working on the core. Relax. Come on up. All right. The last one we're going to do is now we're going to incorporate what we did with the squat jump, working on the core, all right? We're gonna call this what we know as the infamous burpee that nobody likes, but it's so good for you. So here we go. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start in the squatted position, coming down. Darnell is going to explode up, squat down, and then he's gonna drop to a nice good push-up position and extend the feet out. We'll show you the front motion, and then we'll also turn it to give you a side profile view. You ready? I'm going to have to get you some water after this because you are really getting a workout right now.
Thank you.
Okay, so we're going to go slow, and then we're going to do it real fast, real quick. Ready? Okay. So starting once again, you want to be prepared that you really load your quads here. Coming from the joint axis again, ankles, knees, and hips, and back down. So load up, come up, explode, back down, down to the ground, pop out to a nice good burpee. All right, now we're going to do it real time. So you're going to do two,
okay,
and then we'll relax from there. Ready?
Right.
And begin. Down, exploding up, popping back down, out, keeping the core tight, go right back into it, down, explode up high, reach, come back down, extending out, coming back up, and relax, and breathe. Once again, I really, really want to reiterate, this right here is so important in running. Most people forget about the core, which in turn can cause a lot of back pain. So if you're engaging your core in these plyometric movements, you're going to get a stronger back as you get deeper into the mileage of a marathon, even a 10K, even a 5K. You'll finish stronger, and you'll feel much better, and you'll be excited for the next race to come. Thanks a lot. Appreciate you, Darnell. Now go get some water and wipe that sweat off your face.
Thanks, Leona. We're going to continue the spirit of those plyometric movements with a little variety. Yes, it's a sledgehammer. Only 8 pounds, may have it in your garage, but it's a great way to get a great workout. So what we want to do with the sledgehammer is we're creating imbalance. That's going to cause more resistance to be applied, and it helps work with the balance. So a lot of core is involved. If you ever swung a hammer or a baseball bat, you know what I mean. Here today is going to help us out is Jared Tipton. He's preparing for his upcoming professional debut. And we're going to go through some basic movements, then add our dynamic movements. So we're going to start out, Jared. I want you to bring your right hand here. Left hand is there. Good. Let's go to both overhand grip. Let's switch that. All right. We're going to bring it up to your chest. And we're going to start with a simple squat. Now, as you can see, he has it off balance, so that creates more resistance through the core, and go through a regular squat. Just nice, easy. Feet are shoulder width apart. Make sure you're exhaling on your way up. Good. Same thing. Perfect. And he's stabilizing through the core. Keep pushing. Good, and give me one more. All right, and then from there, we're gonna keep the same resistance and the same balance. We're gonna go to a shoulder press. Straight on up for me, Jared. Good. Now notice, he's gotta really engage the core. There's gonna be more work done on that left side because that's where most of the weight is. Good. And you have to work on your grip strength and your latissimus to stabilize that weight. Good. And make sure the hip is nice and straight. Good, and give me one more. Remember, only 8 pounds, but as with anything, the farther you get away from that weight, the more weight is applied. All right, let's switch to an underhand grip. And we're going to go to a basic bicep curl. Both under for me. Good. And as you can see, that left arm is going to do most of the work. Let's go to a bicep curl. And we're still stabilizing. So the whole time, we're engaging the core, and we're working those other supporting muscle groups. Good. Give me three. Perfect. And two. Good. Last one. So we're working upper body, lower body, and always working the core. Now we're going to move to a more dynamic movement. Let's switch this grip. Yeah, let's keep it underneath. And we're going to come straight across. We're going to keep both elbows tight to the body. And we're just going to rotate through the midsection. Let's go, Jared. Good. And what we're doing here is we're working both the positive and the negative resistance. Good. Push. And you may have seen some of these movements on your local magazine or other video. And what you'll often see them do is hitting a tire. Tire is great, but what that does is it actually creates a bounce back effect. What we want is the body always working. Keep going. And working positive and negative resistance. Good. Now we're going to make it a little more dynamic. Let's go to our diagonal. Good. Let's take a nice arm up top. I know that shoulder's working. Good. And we're going to bring it straight across. So we're still working the rotational movement through the core. Good. Keeping the knees nice and soft so we give ourselves a good base. And make sure we're breathing nice and tall. Good. Keep going. And to introduce the lower body into this movement, we're going to add a squat. So let's go through the movement and add a squat at the bottom for me, Jared. Right across. Good. And he's remaining very strict with his arms. That's what we want. We want to always stabilize. Keep going. And the core is nice and tight to stabilize the back. Give me one more. And relax. Now, I'll give you an idea of some of the training we do for Jared for his upcoming fight. We're going to go to more rotational movement. This helps with kicking and punching and also great workout for the core. So let's go back to the same grip. And we're going to go to that circle over the top. Boom. Good. So we're going over the shoulder and straight down the center. Keep going. And what we're doing also, we're making sure we stop below, just below the belly button. We never wanted to go below our hips so that, again, we're stabilizing through the body and working the core to the max. Good. One more. Good. And when we, again, we want to introduce the lower body, we add our squat. So as we come over to the top, we add our squat. Boom. Good. Same thing. Push. Good. Last one. Excellent. Good. So what do you think about that sledgehammer, Jared?
It's a pretty good workout.
And I will use this for general fitness clients, but as well as my fighters. So if you're doing judo or jiu-jitsu or mixed martial arts, or in Jared's case, kickboxing, it's a great workout. Back to you, Joyce.
As we get better, we have to change in order to challenge ourselves. Jared Tipton has a 9-5 record as an amateur kickboxer. He is the 2014 WKA National Champion. He has fought on the undercards of Lion 17, Lion Fight 17, that is, and Glory 19. This month, he makes his pro debut. Welcome Jared Tipton to Fitness 365, your pro debut as a kickboxer this month. You got to be a little bit more excited than this right now,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, thanks, Joyce. You know, it's actually a huge deal. The guy I'm fighting, I actually fought before as an amateur, and I lost a close decision. So, you know, it's kind of like making my payback, and I've been working really hard, and I've gone through a lot to get to this point in my career. So I've come a long way since that last fight, and I just want to come and show and prove it.
Yeah, one of the things I wanted to talk to you about is your journey to kickboxing as a professional. A lot of people watch it on television, or they'll watch MMA, people in the cage, and say, oh, I want to jump up and do that. It's not that simple. Talk about everything you've been through, the workouts, the lifestyle changes, all the sacrifices.
You know, it's definitely not that simple. A lot of people have a different difficulty in the career. For some people, it's diet. For some people, it's just getting to the gym. For some people, it's the small stuff. For me, the hardest things for me is like the little things like jump roping and shadow boxing, but it's that extra stuff that makes you better. So I train about 6 days a week. I don't have a regular job. I quit my job to do this professionally. I used to work full-time at a trucking company, and I decided I'm just not a 9-to-5 kind of guy. Uh-huh. So I'd rather get punched in the face for a living, I guess.
Well, you're special. That's good for you. And one of the things people don't realize is that sometimes you have to make sacrifices in other areas of your life in order to do that. You financially, when you're not a full-time job but doing it this way. We're talking about change. We're talking about changing of the season, changing of your workout. How much do you change your workout as you prepare for a fight?
Well, you know, I try to change a lot depending on who I'm going against, because some guys have different styles. So we have to prepare differently for different people. The drilling is different. I'll usually spar with different partners. And Coach D will put us on different programs in advanced sports performance, whether it be getting stronger or getting faster or building more endurance to prepare for a longer fight.
Did he pay you to say his name? Coach D, call him Coach.
Gotta give credit.
He talked about you earlier in the show. Now you're calling him Coach.
You got to give credit where credit's due.
Most definitely. He does an excellent job when he's training the fighters, and he's all about change. Every time you work out with D'Angelo, it is something different. Now, earlier he was working with you with the sledgehammer. How does that help you? He was talking about the core when you get into the ring.
You know, that actually helps a lot because it helps with your endurance as well as, like you said, your core. Your core is actually where all your power comes from and your punches and your kicks, so you need to have a strong core when you are fighting.
All right, we're at the fight. How's it going to play out?
Well, I don't want to sound cocky, but I'm going for a first-round knockout.
You're going for a first-round knockout?
I feel a lot stronger, and I'm faster than I've ever been before, so I'm feeling pretty confident going into this fight.
Well, congratulations to you. We look forward to you making your pro debut as a kickboxer. Thank Jared so much for coming on the Fitness 365.
I'm in Ashburn, Virginia at the Phenom Gym, and it just so happens to be the home to fitness phenom Steve Hayes.
A cardiac arrest attacked 8 months ago in August when doctors counted him out. Still didn't stop him. He was back in the gym just 2 weeks later.
I'm a firm believer that a healthy body enhances a healthy mind, and I apply both, because if your body is healthy, when I mean healthy, I'm talking about where you're doing the right things for your body, that's going to allow the blood to circulate into the brain. It's going to cause you to think positive and start doing positive things. And one little bitty thing can accelerate itself to something bigger. I have never thought that I could not do anything. If we couldn't do it, we wouldn't think about it. So which means that the premise has already been set.
Considered to be a fitness guru, and for good reason. Steve is still going strong, even
at the tender age of 63, and he has no plans on stopping anytime soon. So what is your workout on a weekly basis?
Well, see, my workout on a weekly basis would be 3 days of lifting, 2 days of intense aerobic. When I say intense aerobic, that entails me doing sprint work and running the step.
Okay, so this is
this is agility drill. You don't want to hear your feet.
You don't want to hear your feet.
And that's why you're running on those toes.
Okay, I'm going to follow behind you. Okay, ready? So you shouldn't hear my feet. Pump those knees up. Pump those knees up. All right, I did it. You didn't hear me, did you? Okay. And so this has helped you build your arms, your chest.
Chest, shoulders, abs, everything.
Everything,
it's
total, core.
It's total upper body.
Wearing his signature Omega compression tank, he's all business, and rightfully so. After all, his motto is go the Hayes way or go home. Go to thehayesway.com if you want more information, or just if you want to order his DVDs, go to thehayesway.com and get his fitness. It's only 17 minutes long, too. Go figure. Anyway. Anyway, it's your girl. I'll see you guys next time. Later. Bye.
I'm here with your April nutrition tip. We're going to be talking about fresh produce in season. So I think the big thing with produce is that when it's in season, it's going to taste even better. So really trying to eat locally and in season is going to make your food taste even better. So today we have some strawberries, which are in season for April and May, and also spinach. So what better way than to enjoy both of them at the same time and have a smoothie? So in part of the smoothie, we're going to add some strawberries. About a cup is a serving, so we want to try and stick to 1 to 2 cups of fruit per smoothie. So today we're going to use a cup of strawberries and a half a banana. When it comes to the spinach, some people may have a hard time at first, but really you can't taste it much, and the blender will do a great job of changing up the texture. It may make it a little bit green, but it's a good way to get another serving of vegetables in. So you may start with one handful and slowly increase it and see what you think. We also want to make sure that there's some type of protein in this smoothie. Protein is responsible for helping you to feel full and satisfied. If it's just fruits and vegetables, you may find that you're hungry a couple hours later, and we really want to make this last. So one example might be some hemp protein. They have some protein powders, hemp hearts, you can dump right in there, a protein powder, peanut butter, nuts, even yogurt or silken tofu make great additions of protein to this smoothie. Today we're going to be using some coconut milk to add a little bit of the fluid to the smoothie. You can use milk, almond milk, really get creative on that end as well. If you're using fruit juice, just want to be mindful of how much fruit juice is going in there, because that would increase the sugar and a little bit more fruit to that smoothie. So today we would be using just this magic bullet. It's really quick and easy. There's definitely a whole span of blenders out there. I really encourage you to keep it on your countertop so that you use it, because if not, it's going to be really hard to put this into practice. So enjoy your smoothie and have fun.
That's going to do it for another edition of Fitness 365. Remember, you can watch Laurel TV on Comcast Channel 71 and Verizon Channel 12.
And also check us out online at laureltv.org.
There you will find all of our programming schedules, and you can find out what time Fitness 365 comes on, plus other shows that are streaming live. Now, D'Angelo, if someone wanted to get in touch with you, get some advice, get some online coaching, how do they do that?
As always, you can reach me online at advancedsportsperformance.com. That's A-D-V-A-N-C-E-D, sportsperformance.com. And social media as well, Advanced Sports Performance. And on Twitter, at Advanced Sports.
All right, thank you so much. That is all for this show. Change is a good thing. For D'Angelo and Leona, I'm Joyce Jackson, telling you to be happy and be healthy.